We're glad you're here this evening. I want you to take just a moment to make sure your cell phone is silent so that we don't have that interrupting. Would you please help me welcome Dr. Nicholas Ciraldo from the University of Southern Mississippi.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for having me. I'd like to thank the Itawamba community for this opportunity to perform an evening of solo guitar music for you. I'd like to thank the warm students and faculty for welcoming me to the music program here today, to Dr. Cass Patrick, and especially to Professor Jeffrey Myers for coordinating the event today. For arranging tonight's concert and so much more, and just being a very friendly new friend in music. I had the opportunity to work with a guitar student here. I had a chance to practice all afternoon. If any of you in music were wondering who that guy was in the choir room practicing all day, that was me. And I'm happy to show you what I was working on. Tonight's program is basically a collection of three large multi-movement works or sonatas and some of the best music that you can hear on the guitar, in my opinion. Starting with one of the titans of music, Johann Sebastian Bach, moving on to one of the great composers for this instrument from the 19th century, Fernando Sor, and moving on to one of the greatest Latin American composers of all time, Alberto Ginastera. The second two pieces, the works by Sor and Ginastera, were written for the guitar. The first work, obviously being a cello suite, was not. I arranged the work about 7 or 8 years ago. It was originally in E flat major, and I have arranged it for C major. Guitarists like to play the first, third, and fifth suites, the odd ones, and so I'm giving you tonight the rare opportunity to hear the number four suite. I hope you enjoy, and I'd like to dedicate tonight's concert to a guitar student who I had the pleasure of working with this afternoon. He's doing very well, and I wish him very, very much and all the best in his musical endeavors. Thank you and enjoy. So the great Johann Sebastian Bach, Baroque composer, never wrote for the guitar, so we arranged his music. The next composer wrote only for guitar. It is written that he wrote for ballet and maybe a couple operas, but I've not seen them. He has a huge amount of music for solo guitar and some beautiful duos, guitar and guitar as well. And so, whereas we don't have some of the great classical and romantic composers like Mozart or Beethoven that we can play on the guitar, we do have Fernando Sor, who I think is probably the closest you can get to those composers in terms of quality. And this four-movement sonata does a good job of getting at that goal. It has a typical sonata allegro first movement, the slow second movement, minuet and trio as a third movement, and then a sort of a fun rondo to close out the work. It also is in C major, so that may still be ringing in your ears from the Bach. It's one of certainly my favorite composers to play, and I hope you enjoy the sonata Opus 22 by Fernando Sor. Excuse me, I think there was a fly that wanted to dance with me during the minuet. Well, now you're about to hear something completely different. We've been in the land of tonality and consonants and a fairly gentle playing of the instrument, and now you're about to see me do something that you may not have ever seen before done on the guitar. I'll be playing what are called extended techniques, using the instrument in a way that is not normally to be used and to make sort of new sounds. I play the guitar very aggressively, I bang on the instrument, I do all kinds of crazy things. Why? Because Alberto Ginastera was very much into that, was into composing in an avant-garde style. He wrote in a dodecaphonic language, 12-tone music, if you're familiar with that. Just some of the most cutting-edge stuff of the time. And we're just so very thankful that he wrote a sonata for the guitar, because he wrote for all other kinds of instruments in one piece for the guitar. Some think this is the greatest sonata written for the guitar from the 20th century. And I have to agree sometimes. I have to add one little thing to the face of the guitar. Just a little bit of protective plastic. Don't worry, I'm not going to set fire to the instrument or anything like that, but it does get a little aggressive. In four movements, first movement is very sort of declamatory and grand. The second movement, the scherzo, is very fast and has all these sort of wonderful little whimsical moments. The third is a beautiful song. And the fourth movement is when I really start to rock out. Once again, thank you very much for your attention. Thank you for coming. Thank you to the wonderful Itawamba Music Program for having me, and I hope you have a wonderful night. I do teach at the University of Southern Mississippi. Very proud to be part of that program. And if you have any interest in chatting about the school with me afterward, please feel free to track me down afterward.